So, this is Rocky. Thank you so much for joining my channel. And today is a vlog day. Whenever you guys see me starting out in these odd positions, I'll be, you know, either in my car or in the bathroom or wandering my house. You already know it's going to be a vlog. So, I'm trying to adjust here so that you don't fall. But yeah, so I am starting this vlog actually rather late in the day. I have a few things that I want to do. I want to take you along with. I'll show you my outfit of the day. Damn it, I forgot this block is blocked off. You know, I live down the street from the Obamas. So I always forget that their block is still blocked off with the Secret Service and blockades and all that stuff. So I always have to redirect myself. But anyway, I do have some errands to run. I'm gonna show you my outfit of the day. I got a little house hunting that I'm doing. I think I might've shared with you guys that I'm mildly doing some house hunting. I'm planning to move, but I'm taking my time and making sure I get the right thing. So I will be taking you guys along on that. Every time I drive, the camera moves, so we're working through that, of course. But anyway, so I'll take you guys along on that. I have a couple errands that I need to run, and I'm going out to dinner. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go out to dinner. So I'm gonna take you guys on all of that, and hopefully you find that to be interesting. I always love showing you guys my city. Even though my city doesn't always love me back, I do love showing you my city of Chicago. So we're gonna be doing that today, and let's get into it. So we are running an errand to go to Target. You can see all the signage here. I am running an errand here. Hopefully I'm going the right way. This should be really quick, but let's get into it. So today I decided to somewhat have my hair out. Still dealing with the thin girl thing, but this is my hair. Outfit of the day. You guys just saw me haul this dress from Forever 21. It's a little bit too big actually, but I'm still wearing it. It's comfy. I like it. I'm wearing this with my rainbow Randall Loffler sandals, and of course my rainbow MCM bag. So I'm kind of coordinating. I have my hair clipped up with a you can't see it, but there's a curl clip in my hair. So that's how I am dressed today. I have on my Stella McCartney shades, and that's my look for today. So I only come to Target. Guys, you can mute this if you don't want to hear this, but I only come to Target to get sanitary. I only get my sanitary napkins from Target. There's a brand that I like, L Period. A long time ago, maybe 3-4 years ago, I started to go to natural products, and this is one of them where it has no fragrance, dyes, and all the things. I forget how to get to the store from over here, but it doesn't have any fragrance, dyes, and all that stuff in it, and it's not bleached. So that's what I like about it. So I've, you know, my diet has been better. all the things that I use on my body, most of the things I use on my body are natural, no deodorant, all the things. So I'm just trying to keep from using things that promote or cause cancer. So these are the ones that I get. It's L Period, chlorine free, no synthetic pesticides, dyes, fragrances, all the things. And it's you know, pretty decent price. You get 42 for $6.99. And I would do Honey Pop, but these have like fragrance, and some of them have fragrance in them. I don't know, I've not really tried their products, but I don't, let me see. I think the pads that I saw once had, but these work for me. A bit longer than I can appreciate, or bigger, but it's good. So even though I'm headed out to dinner, there is a Starbucks in here I couldn't resist. I got an iced guava passion fruit coconut milk drink. That's what I wanted the last time I went out, but they didn't have any. A lot of places are having inventory problems. So I'm gonna get my drink, even though I'm headed to dinner in like 2 hours or so. Again, I was just telling you guys, I'm going like doing a house hunting thing. So I'm gonna show you one of the places today. It's right in downtown Chicago, and let's see what we think about that. I forgot that I don't like this Target. And I'm gonna tell you why. Well, today it wasn't an issue, but I came here one time to get something and they didn't have it in stock in inventory.
And they didn't validate my parking because I needed to have purchased something in order to validate. So it reminded me that I didn't want to be here at this particular one when I left. So I paid for my things. I went to the Starbucks and I went to get validated. It's like, oh, we need your receipt. And I'm like, what you need the receipt for? Oh, we just need to scan the receipt. And so if I came in there again today and didn't find what I needed, they would not have validated my parking. That's crazy. That is absolutely, to me, bonkers that I visited your store and I need to pay to park because I didn't. Anyway, I'm done ranting, but they had to scan my receipt in order to validate. And I think that's BS. And that reminds me not to come to this one again, just out of pure, it's the principalities. It's the principles. So anyway, we're going to head out of here. I just got my tasty beverage. It is the iced guava passion fruit. Like I said before, I really, really like this one. It's a ton of sugar in it, of course, but I like it. I just got through talking about eating better and being healthy and natural, and then I go get this bullshit. So good. So this is one of the places, like I said, we're downsizing. So this is like the living room, dining room area, kitchen. I'm impressed with the kitchen because it's a lot of cabinetry for such a small space. This is the view. It is pretty cool. You guys probably remember some of this when I'm walking down the street on some of my other vlogs, but this is the view, my city. And you can't see this too well over here because I have. But anyway, so this is the living room space. This also has a balcony, which not really my thing because I'm afraid of heights. So we're going to stand back a bit. I'm not necessarily going to be looking downwards. But the same thing we saw just a second ago. So that's that. My husband likes those types of spaces. Not my thing. So there is plenty of closet space. So this is the washer and dryer. This is the first bedroom, which is small. I think I'm going to be using this for, you know, filming and guest bedroom and things like that. I'll put a let out couch in here, I think, so that people can, you know, visit or, you know, whatever. I don't know. Here's the first bathroom. It's a two bed, two bath in total. And it has a shower. And then this is the master suite. We're gonna start this way with the bathroom. Let's get you in here. So this is the bathroom. Hello, that's me again. Only thing I don't like is that it doesn't have double sinks, but with it just being a few of us in here, I don't think that's a big deal because there is another bathroom. But this is the bathroom. I'm gonna save the closet for last. This is the bedroom. It's actually a really decent sized space. There is another small closet in here. So I think this is for like your jackets and stuff like that. I think I would build this out a little bit better. And then again, lots of floor to ceiling windows here. And you can also, you know, change it so that you can get more light in or have different types of window coverings. And then this is the closet. It's nowhere near as big as the closet that I currently have, of course, but this is the closet. So I can build this out to make it, you know, a bit more useful, like more rungs and, you know, get it, not more rungs, but just like a better closet, just get it built in. But I don't think that this is awful. The only thing I don't like about the place, and I think I might have, did I say this already? But I'm not a carpet person, but there is carpet. But I do like wood floor. That brings us to the end of the tour. There was another closet there, which I appreciate. I do like a lot of closets. All right, so this is part of the outdoor space. It's really pretty. We'll see what it has. I'm gonna do this quickly because I don't want anybody to get mad at me if there's somebody out here. But I don't think I saw anybody from the windows. Oh, wow. Oh my word. Don't you just love it? Look at that. Like if there's a concert, I could hear it from here. I could see it from here. Look at this. The lake is right there. Right there. Oh my. Wow. What do we think? What do we think, you guys? This side is not as appealing, but still, this right there is amazing. And this is the view. Like, I can see all of this stuff. Oh my gosh. Nice. I would love to know your opinion in the comments down below.
So I really liked it. I forgot to show you guys the rest of the view and the amenities and all of that. It was so nice. They had all these outdoor spaces. The community room and spaces are nice. They have a full pool. And there was just like nobody there. Which for a weekend, it really surprises me that there would be like not packed and not a lot of competition for the space. So I am feeling that one. We're going to continue to look, of course, not make that our last stop, but I'm feeling it. You let me know what you thought.
So we landed at a place called Sienna Tavern. This is the menu. I'm not sure what we got. I think maybe some pizza. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But everywhere else had a wait, so that's why we're here. And I'll show you the food.
Is there anything else I can bring in right now, folks?
Nope, I think we're good.
Well, I hope
you enjoy. Ooh, this looks good. These are called bombolinis. So I think they're like donuts that you dip or something. But I don't know. What is this like? Beignets a little bit, right? But I guess Italian version. But that looks good. So we just finished dinner. You're not in the shot. We just finished dinner. It was really, really good. So I would recommend Sienna Tavern. Now it was, I would say somewhat pricey because it was the two of us and we just have regular meals, no alcohol. And what was the bill? $108 without tip. So I would say somewhat pricey. We're not, you know, huge eaters, not like a bunch of appetizers or anything like that. So. That's the only thing I will give you the heads up on, but it was worth it. It was so delicious. You have to get the bombolini dessert. It's kind of like beignets. Yeah, I would say it was like beignets. And they're like a cross between yeast and cake donuts in a way, but then you get it with like these dipping sauces and so good. So anyway, the rest of my day is going to be pretty boring. The top part of my day was relatively boring, as you can see, but the rest of it is going to be even more boring. I have work to do, and I'm just going to be sitting up watching Hallmark like I usually do. So I'm going to end it here, and thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Leave me any comments below. Hit the like button. Share with your friends. Mm-hmm.